17, every Thursday, we invite you, the viewer, to call in with your questions and concerns for Dr. Kalani Brady. You think he's been missed? We missed him. He's back from a two-week vacation, Doc. Ohayou gozaimasu.
Ohayou gozaimasu.
Good fun, huh? Genki desu. How about you?
Hi, genki desu.
Lots of food, huh?
Lots of wonderful food.
I love Japan. All right, let's get to the questions. What would cause the pigment on someone's face to lose its color in patches?
This is most likely an autoimmune disease we call vitiligo, and it's not a curable disease. It's a frustrating disease. It's basically where the body fights itself, like rheumatoid arthritis and lupus, but the battleground is the skin. So the body kills the melanocytes that cause pigment, and you get these white patches or hypopigmented patches. It's not only on the face; it's other places, but it's most visible on the face.
Yes, a lot of people have it on their hands, on their arms too. Okay, this is a very important call. Question I want to get to. I'm 57 years old. I had two prior strokes. I cannot use my left side when I walk. I'm overdue for a colonoscopy. Is there any way to prepare for the colonoscopy besides the standard prep? By the way, my mom has colon cancer. Our prayers to mom.
So this person actually has an increased risk for colon cancer, and it's very frustrating, obviously, to sort of pseudo live on a toilet for 12 hours or so during the prep. But that's really the only way to clean out the colon so you can look at the colon during the colonoscopy. So I would try and find some help, a friend, a very close friend, or someone to assist during the prep. But the prep is really the only way to do it.
And to do it correctly is the only way to do it.
Really?
Yeah, no shortcuts there. All right, I'm 55 years old. I have a lot of dry skin, mostly on my legs. Am I lacking something? What can I do?
It's a frustrating problem. Imagine how lucky we live in Hawaii, because if we were in a drier climate, it would even be worse. However, the standard skin moisturizers that you can get in supermarkets and drugstores should help. You have to use them regularly or the skin will dry out again, and that will keep the skin more moist. Obviously, you want to treat this on a regular basis, because if you don't, you'll get other potential infections of the skin and other problems.
So it's nothing to do with a lack of water or anything like that?
No, it isn't, really.
Okay.
And eating oil will not help.
Not help at all. Okay, I'm going to ask it. How old are you today, Doc? This caller wants to know.
61.
61 and looking great.
Oh, thanks.
Great. Okay, let's move on. I'm 73 years old. I have a black spot on the side of my tummy, my stomach, and also under my breast. What's causing this?
You know, at that point, it's really wise to go in to see the doctor, because we can't see it here on the air, and this is possibly something that's serious. So go in and see your friendly neighborhood doctor.
Okay. I just started to get this dry cough. What can I do about it?
There's a medication that helps some, and it's called guaifenesin DM. Dextromethorphan is what the DM stands for, but we know it as Robitussin and Long's Tussin and Safeway Tussin DM. How do you remember DM, Ron, with all those other letters?
Right.
The doctor's medicine, DM.
Doctor's medicine. Just like that.
Just like that.
You are our medicine every Thursday. Thank you for being with us.
My pleasure.
And welcome back. We missed you.
Thank you.
And I know they did too.
Thank you.
Say hi to everybody.
Hi there.